इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड सपोर्टेड बाय नीति आयोग, स्टार्टअप इंडिया एंड इन्वेस्ट इंडिया एंड पावर्ड बाय रेजर पे, ब्रॉट टू यू बाय अमेजॉन पे, व्हाट्सएप इन एसोसिएशन विद पार्टनर गूगल पे, ओपन फाइनेंशियल टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड डिजिटल पेमेंट्स पार्टनर कैश फ्री पेमेंट्स. We are here today to discuss a very crucial topic on next wave of digital payments. Without any further ado, let me invite our keynote speaker, Mr. Manish Mahatme. He is the Director India from WhatsApp Payments. I would request our audience to put in your questions in the chat box and we will try to respond to few of them by the end of the session. Over to you, Mr. Mahatme.
Thanks a lot, and thanks everyone for joining. It's great to be part of the Global FinTech Festival. I think it's a really fabulous meeting of beautiful minds, and also great to see how India's fintech and startup stories are creating new benchmarks, right? And a lot of these we've heard over the last couple of days. I'm privileged to share WhatsApp's view on what it'll take to build payments for Bharat. So that we can enable the next wave of digital payments for India. Let me start by saying that there hasn't been a better time to be born, isn't it? To witness the building of this nation, the optimism of a young country and all this and entrepreneurial energy that's building, this nation together, right? To push our economy forward. I think we are all bound by this common spirit to just get better, do more, and add more value to themselves, their families, and the country. We've covered some of these foundational contributions, but and these contributions over the last decade or so have actually brought us here. Whether it is really on access through smartphones, data, innovations through fintech. Right. And the sort of the Jandan Aadhaar Mobile or the Jam Trinity, I think it is a fabulous gift of the last decade. We're seeing to see some of the benefits now. UPI from NPCI is one such, and that has enabled millions of users to get into the digital payments fold. But I really think and we believe that we're just getting started on our journey, right? More than 80% of consumer spending continues to be in cash. Two-thirds of India, which is in rural, will start seeing benefits of digital innovations going forward. Right? And all of us, guess what? All of us will need to come together to take us there. But what will it take? Right? And what is India telling us about sort of barriers and problems that we need to solve for. As we move through this presentation, I will try and cover a bit more, right? We'll understand some of the voices from Bharat that we are seeing and we've heard. We'll also cover WhatsApp's vision on payments and financial inclusion, right? And also try and give you a sneak peek on how this vision is shaping up into actions at WhatsApp. So if we need to make it happen and bring the next 500 million digital payment users to the ecosystem, what do we need to do, right? We spoke to users who are new to digital payments or haven't tried digital payments yet across the length and breadth of the country to try and understand what it will take actually to adopt digital payments, right? Well, the good news is that a lot of the drivers still continue to remain familiar to what we've heard in the last few years. But the flip side is that the relative importance of these drivers to these users who are yet to start their digital payments journey is much, much more than users who've already adopted earlier. Right? And this then makes it very important on how these get solved. And the first is the need for simplicity. It is one of the strongest voices across users, across segments, whether it is within rural pockets, whether it is urban pockets that are yet to adopt, etc. Right? Traditionally, users felt intimidated and struggled to find a way how to pay digitally. Right? There's a common question in their mind. While a lot of focus has been on the why, how to make a digital payment, how to discover it, how to you know, sort of evolve as a user, I think these are challenges that come up. And by the way, cash brings all the benefits, right? Whether it is simplicity, familiarity, and therefore digital payments just ends up being an afterthought. So I think the first key message that we are getting is around the need for simplicity. The second key message that we are also hearing is actually the need for building inclusive experiences and products, right? And except for some digital use cases of, you know, largely of the sort of the frequent or recurring kinds, where and what to pay for continues to be a sort of a large theme that seems to be a barrier, right? And therefore the question for us is, how do we get from the first mile to the last mile audience of this, you know, to ensure that, you know, whether it's on rural, whether it is on urban micro ecosystems, how do we ensure that they have the same level of digital ecosystems to facilitate adoption? Because it's a two-sided problem, right, to solve for. And most importantly, trust and safety becomes extremely important for that segment, right? As you go to the next set of users, that concern on trust on safety is also backed very, very interestingly by a very, very acute lack of understanding on what recourse or remediation exists if something goes wrong. So if I make a payment and that payment doesn't go through, right, how will I get my money back? Right? If I register for payments and I lose all my money, you know, where do I go? And you know, so these are very fundamental questions that users who have not adopted digital payments yet are sharing. And one of the things for us to think about is, while these concerns definitely need to be addressed, is there a way that we can also go upstream and try and solve it at the point of adoption itself, right? And that seems to be one constant theme coming in. So just to recap, right, just sort of the voices from users. The first is the need for simplicity. The second is the need for inclusive products and experiences. And the third is the need to build a safety and trust net around how customers adopt digital payments to give them the comfort of transacting. And these largely have been similar to what we've heard. But the key piece is, for the next segment of users, these become extremely, extremely important in their adoption journey. So how do we, you know, having heard from these users and what they need and what they want, how should we solve for these, and so that we can truly drive adoption and meaningful inclusion in the next set of users, right? First, at WhatsApp, I think we are genuinely privileged to have the opportunity to contribute to the effort. Right? More than 400 million users use WhatsApp every month, a large percentage of that actually daily. More than 15 million small businesses use WhatsApp for their daily business purposes, right? Whether it is to connect with their customers or share images about their work, or just to carry out their daily business. You know, to give you an example, you know, there's a micro entrepreneur in Bangalore who makes really good sort of natural bath products, and the only way that she communicates with customers is by sharing a set of pictures and a PDF of her catalog, which is how a lot of these small and micro businesses are operating today. We are already available in more than 10 languages, and therefore, we are in a very good place to serve that need. Right? And while all the sort of previous numbers show the immense trust that our users place in us, more than 80% of WhatsApp users tell us that they are very keen on using payments on WhatsApp. And the most interesting part about this is, a lot of users who are currently not using digital payments also share that keenness, and which brings me Which brings me to how we are thinking. What is sort of our mission, vision? Our vision is to empower every Indian with access to payments and financial services, thereby accelerating economic empowerment and financial inclusion. Now, how does this vision sort of translate into what we are doing and bringing it, sort of to reality? So we've already connected 400 million users who trust us on chat, audio, and video calls, right? We know that. We use that. We are daily users, a lot of us. We are building on that with payments on WhatsApp, built on, sort of foundational pillars, and we'll cover some of this later, including simplicity and trust, and that's what we heard earlier. To make digital payments truly mainstream and part of every user's daily life. Right. A critical part of our strategy with this is to empower businesses to connect with those customers on WhatsApp and accept payments from them. And for millions of these businesses connecting with their customers using WhatsApp, receiving a payment instantly will be a huge enabler. So if you are, say, the best sourdough bread maker in India based in Malleshwaram in Bangalore, or a home entrepreneur selling traditional saris, sourced from your hometown in Rajasthan, or say a small business in the Northeast selling spices across India, right? We want you to connect with your customers and get payments from your customers for the business that you're doing. Now, as we built this, this two-sided platform of users and businesses and connect them with payments, it allows us to actually democratize access to use cases, right? And let me explain to you what I mean by that. When you have a user and you have a business and you've tied them up with payments and that platform already exists, the two-sided platform already exists, right? Across the length and breadth of this country, no matter how unique the business activity that you're engaged in, or no matter how remotely you're present, we see WhatsApp and payments on WhatsApp as a railroad for that economic activity, right? Just like many other foundational inputs we've actually seen before, right? And a very important part of our strategy or approach is that we have a responsibility to then build on this platform and start offering meaningful and relevant financial services, providing true empowerment and inclusion for all. Whether it is around coming up with bite-sized financial instruments or products around micro insurance, micro pension, etc. We see this as a sense of responsibility in our sort of true eventual calling and our point of arrival. Right. So that's our approach, which speaks to the vision that I spoke to earlier. Right. And but when you actually look at this approach, what it creates is a million possibilities. Right. So it's one thing to try and figure out each different use case and build for it. But what we think we can bring uniquely, right, is that this platform-based approach tied with payments allows any use case, any corner of the country, to reach directly to customers and start doing economic activity. Right. For example, it could be a government program in Bicholim Taluka in Goa, where a user also needs to co-participate, or it could be a small sort of not-for-profit raising funds for a local cause, which is very unique and requires that not-for-profit to connect with customers locally. We see ourselves enabling and facilitating that over as we go, or a doctor in some remote part of UP who would like to do teleconsultations, and because there is no way to collect payments today, it creates a barrier to reach and serve patients. So we spoke about the vision and we spoke about the approach that we are following and what it unlocks, right? But a very important part is how are we going and building it, right? How are we going about it? And while we do that, I think we are guided by three very fundamental principles. I think these are principles that form the ethos of what WhatsApp is and how we've been able to be, you know, trusted by millions of users already. And these three are: one, the need to keep it simple. And we'll talk about some of these and go through what we are doing there. The need to keep it inclusive and the need to build a trusted platform that users with all at all levels of sophistication can be comfortable using, right? I'm going to share a short video of what, you know, to say a little bit more about payments on WhatsApp. Let's just hope this works. Okay, so what does simple mean, right? And for starters, we've made sending money as simple as sending a picture, right? My mother is 69, right? And she lives back home in Goa. And 15 years ago, I couldn't have imagined her using any digital product. And for her, actually, a smartphone is no different from a landline where you actually just key in the numbers just to make a call, right? But imagine where just a simple product has taken her into her digital sort of journey, right? Today, she spends a considerable amount of time on WhatsApp, and she may not be the most comfortable typing messages and full sentences, right? She uses stickers, she uses pictures and calls and sometimes even voice messages, right? And so to stay in touch with her friends and God knows what, sometimes all of these good morning messages that keep going on. But what we've done in payments is we've taken that very core insight, right, of making it so simple as if it's sending a message or sending a picture, right? And replicated that in our payment experience to make it as simple. So, you know, right where you're in chat, you can just attach a payment and you're done. It's as simple as that, right? And you can send that money to whoever is in your contacts and you're done. So it's just one example of simplicity, right? Here's something more that we've built, right? And what we've seen is payments, and going back to this whole simplicity theme, payments is always, making a payment is always a very deliberate step, right? I need to open an app. I need to know which option to click. I need to know or find out how to pay. And each of these steps, believe me, for customers who are just starting their digital journey, is extremely intimidating and sometimes frightening, right? And each of these steps takes a lot of learning. But true inclusion is when customers don't have to do that, right? And an arrival point is when payments just fit seamlessly into the customer's intrinsic behavior, right? And so let's play this out. Hundreds of millions of customers send WhatsApp messages every day. Spend many minutes on WhatsApp, take a picture, send pictures, right? In fact, for a majority of customers, when they unlock their phone, it's very likely that WhatsApp is the app that's open, right? So we went about thinking, what if we bring payments right there? So we took two of the most well understood and iconic symbols that all Indians understand, whether regardless of how old you are, how sophisticated in your digital journey or evolved you are, or where you are in the country, everybody understands them. The first is the icon of camera, right? Millions of Indians today click on the camera icon on WhatsApp and use that to take a picture and send it, right? And it's the source of so many of these happy birthday flower messages and good morning messages, etc. Right? Very happy to share that now you can use that same WhatsApp camera to scan any UPI QR and pay at more than 20 million stores in India. It doesn't matter which QR code it is. Just scan using WhatsApp and just pay right there in the app that you love the most. Right? So that's the first sort of icon or first sort of truly inclusive experience that we built. Right? The second and most important symbol is our very own rupee. Right? For millions of users, Indians' WhatsApp creates the first experience of what digital inclusion feels like. Right? It's been achievable because it's simple and reliable and easily understandable. Right? Many of us have seen our parents, grandparents, and helpers adopt WhatsApp, right, because of its inclusive features. But you know what? Paying someone or sending money is such an intrinsic and basic need for Indians that it really shouldn't be 3-4 clicks away, right? And going back to that ethos of, you know, building simple products, right? And continuation of our promise, we are introducing the rupee symbol as an integral part of chat itself, right there in chat. And you can see that on the screen there, where every single WhatsApp user will see it every time they chat with anyone. So at any point of time, if they need to send money or make a payment, they can do it right there in chat. Right? Some of you might have already seen this as this is getting rolled out to users over the next few weeks. But this visibility now will drive discoverability with every single WhatsApp user and make engagement with payments very, very intuitive. Right? It cannot get any simpler for any segment of user across the country to now start their digital payments journey. Right? NPCI has created a world-class infrastructure with UPI. And now the rupee symbol getting right in the middle of chat and bringing it right mainstream will further strengthen the way digital payments gets adopted. Just one more thing that's coming soon, right? And there's a lot happening on the slide, and there's a reason for it. There's a story behind every payment, and if we really need to reach the next 500 million, right? We need to make it very relevant for every user and the underlying use case or the underlying need for sending money or making a payment. Right? So this is something coming soon, which is stickers to express yourself no matter what the occasion. Right? So whether it's a mahine ka kiraya, yeah, or a couple of friends sharing, you know, congratulatory messages of badai ho, or just a friend, a son asking his mother for more money and saying, give me more, right? Stickers and images, we believe, will truly democratize payments as they did democratize communication, just beyond the language barrier or any other barrier you can think of. And guess what? This is just the start, right? What we're going to do is we're going to open it up for design. So everyone can build stickers and create stickers that's relevant for them and relevant for that part of the country, right? And by the way, my personal favorite is the Khush Raho, because I think it symbolizes my state of mind right now. Yeah, so we covered what simplicity means for us and how we are tackling and solving for the need for simplicity. How are we solving for trust? Right? I think we are millions of users already trust us today to chat and connect, and some of the core features that we have built on safety that create that trust. But over and above that, we've built some very sort of intrinsic payment specific features that take that trust dimension further. For example, this includes a very, very proactive way to protect your account if you ever change your handset or change your SIM. Right? So for example, if you do change your handset or change your SIM, and we see users doing that, right? We protect your account. So it can't just be used just like that. It requires to be reset and reactivated. We also realize that new users in digital payments are often the most susceptible and often the target of a lot of these social engineering attempts. Right? And payments of WhatsApp is secure for these kind of users as well. So we've covered simplicity, we've covered trust. I want to spend some time on how do we think about democratizing and sort of building, creating a sort of an inclusive platform for all, right? And during the COVID lockdowns, we remember we saw hundreds of these stories of small store owners using WhatsApp as a tool to take and service orders. So, for example, I met a person who organizes these overnight desert safaris and camel rides in a remote place called Khodi, just outside Jaisalmer. Right? So interestingly, this gentleman, the bookings for these overnight safaris are taken by his son on WhatsApp, right? And then this gentleman walks for 90 minutes to the pickup point and picks up customers and then sort of takes them for these overnight safaris and brings them back early morning. But guess what? Sometimes these customers really don't land up, and that costs him a 90-minute walk and potentially other customers. And if he just had, just imagine the impact of accepting a booking fee on WhatsApp and at the time of booking, and how much value that could add to that gentleman's life and his livelihood, right? And so we do realize that need. Right. And thus what we have today is we have more than 15 million small businesses which use WhatsApp for business to connect with their customers. Right. Now, any small business owner who has downloaded the WhatsApp for Business app and uses it can just type in their virtual handle or their UPI address in chat to accept a payment from WhatsApp users. And what's more, WhatsApp for Business also has a quick reply feature where you can actually share your payment address just by using a keyword. So you can save your, just share your payment address by using that keyword, like pay or payment or whatever you choose it could be, right? And just share it, as soon as you enter that keyword, it gets shared as a message, right? But the best part about it is it's fully democratized. Right, you can be registered with any app for UPI. It doesn't matter. All you need to know is just your UPI handle. Right, just share it on WhatsApp and get paid to that address into that bank account, regardless of which UPI handle you have or where you've signed up to accept payments. Right, what you can do is accept payments from any from WhatsApp users, regardless of which handle you want to accept it in. But that's right where you chat with your customers, right? You don't need to do anything extra. So that's actually an example of how we're starting to think about and build inclusive and democratized experiences that just brings this two-sided platform and connects that with payments. And there's more to come going forward. So that were a few examples of sort of the simplicity, the trust, and the sort of democratization democratized approach that we are thinking of building WhatsApp payments. So with that sneak peek into payments at WhatsApp, let me actually summarize how payments fits into our overall vision. Right? our vision is aligned with the national strategy for financial inclusion, which is to create accessible and affordable services. We see ourselves as a true catalyst, right, to serve segments that haven't been yet served and contribute there, as well as add a lot of value to financial instrument financial institutions that that are, you know, want to partner with us to serve those customers. And most importantly, our platform-based approach, we believe, can enable small and medium businesses with really plug-and-play services, right, to unlock their potential. So with that, thanks for listening. And last but not the least, as our Honorable Finance Minister said earlier at this forum, India is a prime destination for digital activities and digital payments. So looking forward to make it happen for Bharat together with the industry. Thank you for the time and keep watching this space. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Mahatme. We are actually almost out of time, but if you would like, we can take up a few questions.
Okay, I'm actually going to go through a few. Happy to take a couple of questions. Okay. Ekta, when will the P2M features be live? Well, I think UPI is a very brilliantly visualized system, right? It's interoperable, and that's, I think, what makes it really special. What you can do now with payments on WhatsApp is you can simply scan any UPI code or UPI QR code to pay at any shop or merchant, right? That gives you access to over 20 million stores today, right? And as we move forward, watch this space for more exciting use cases on WhatsApp. WhatsApp has the potential to go up to 400 million plus consumers. What about the 20 million cap? It's a good question. All I can say is, WhatsApp, we are scaling up in a very phased manner right now, and we are partnering with NBCI to work through the scale. Our focus right now is to currently drive our awareness of our payments feature on WhatsApp and to build new use cases to transact. We will focus on these inputs as we go forward, and watch this space for more. Interesting question. Why doesn't WhatsApp market the pay feature? Thanks for the question. We are beginning to deploy a bunch of marketing and awareness inputs, and we covered some of these in the presentation. A lot of marketing features or marketing assets, as well as core features that allow customers to discover payments, right? As we covered some of the payment features itself. But very soon, in addition to all of that that we are doing, you will see us deploying some more marketing efforts, you should watch out for it. That might be coming sooner. Okay, I think we are at time.
Yes, thank you so much, Mr. Mahatme, for your time, and I would also like to thank our audience for joining us today. And this session is brought to you by WhatsApp. Please stay tuned for other exciting sessions. We are signing off. Thank you so much.